Welcome back to MC Studios in Brisbane, where we performance test solar panels and crash test solar inverters in order to cut through the solar industry marketing garbage and find out how current solar products really work. Today, we're talking about a new microinverter on the Australian market, Hoymiles, and I'll be comparing it to Enphase microinverters. But before we get stuck in, remember to give me a thumbs up for this video. It really helps out my channel. Now, let me be clear from the outset. I'm not the biggest fan of microinverters. They have their place and we do use them when required. But I think that place is becoming more and more niche as string inverters get better and better. Microinverters are not necessarily the best shade solution, as I explain or even prove in this video. Besides, with most solar panels, you can void your warranty if the panels are ever shaded. You heard me right. Check out this link for that crazy story. Now, while it is true that micros are safer than old-school string inverters, it would be a stretch to call them safer than a modern string inverter with fully functioning arc fault circuit interruption. But that's an argument for a future video. For me, microinverters just introduce more parts, and more parts equal more future failure points. Now, however, there are some situations that microinverters are necessary. For example, if you have a ridiculously heavily shaded roof, or if you have such a small and complicated roof that just a few panels can be installed in one orientation. But which microinverter is better? The new kid on the block Hoymiles or the industry-leading Enphase microinverter? So who is this new kid on the block and why have they made such a stir in the Australian market? While Hoymiles is new to Australia, they are no slouch of a company. The Chinese microinverter company that started less than 10 years ago now has over 500 employees, including over 60 engineers in R&D. But let's cut to the chase. The reason that everyone is talking about Hoymiles is because they are cheap. With Hoymiles' most popular offering, a 6.6 kilowatt system could be up to $1,500 cheaper than Enphase. That makes it interesting. You get the flexibility of a microinverter for the price of a string inverter. But how do Hoymiles make microinverters so cheap? Well, simple. With the use of 4-for-1 micros. A 4-for-1 microinverter is an inverter with 4 maximum power point trackers. So you can connect 4 panels to one rooftop inverter, but each panel will work independently of each other. So in this situation, instead of having 20 inverters on the roof, you could have 5 inverters on the roof. But the 5 inverters each have 4 trackers. So each panel works independently, just like with Enphase. So in theory, design flexibility is as good as Enphase, but with far fewer components. But we'll see which inverter actually works better a little bit later. Now let's talk about the practicalities and legalities of using a 4-for-1 microinverter. Well, for a start, under the current rule book that has been used throughout 2021, you can't practically legally use them in Australia. So if you installed a Hoymiles 4-for-1 microinverter in Australia before November 2020, it's probably not compliant. Check AS5033 clause 4.3.12 if you don't believe me. Sorry about the bad news. But the good news is that the new version of the Australian Standards for Solar Installations is due right about now. By the time that you're listening to this, you can probably use a 4-for-1 microinverter. There are a couple of problems though. You'll most likely need to make up short extension cables for the microinverter to the panel, which will cost more in time and components and money. The cheap microinverter is getting a little bit less cheap. And here's the second problem. Remember how I said micros are often good for smaller and more complicated roofs? If you have a small or complicated roof with anything other than groups of 4 panels, then you'll want to use 2-for-1 Hoymiles micros or 1-for-1 Hoymiles micros, which are really not much cheaper than Enphase. So that $1,500 saving that I was talking about on a 6 kilowatt system will be very unlikely. But let's assume that groups of 4 panels work in your favor and you can save bucket loads compared to Enphase. Let's look at how Hoymiles' monitoring solution works. Well, the monitoring hardware is easier to install and it's cheaper than Enphase. All we need to do is plug in this little data transfer unit into a PowerPoint inside, preferably near your switchboard. You'll also want to install a consumption meter at the switchboard and hardwire that consumption monitor to that little DTU box. Now compare that with Enphase. Enphase require this huge and expensive box with communications and a relay to disconnect the microinverters in case of a fault. You'll need to be a Sparky to install this, and if it fails, you'll need a Sparky to repair it. And if any part fails outside of the 5-year warranty, it's not particularly cheap to fix. As a side note, if you don't keep your Enphase continuously connected to the internet, then you'll void your warranty on your microinverter. I'm serious. Check out their terms and conditions. At least Hoymiles doesn't have that get out of jail free clause written into their terms and conditions. So for monitoring and hardware, for multiple reasons, I'm saying Hoymiles wins on cost and simplicity. But now let's talk about the online monitoring platform. I've been using Enphase monitoring on and off for nearly 10 years. I do generally like Enphase as a product, and you'd think I'd like their monitoring platform because it's familiar to me. But I don't really like Enphase monitoring at all. I think that the installer login is clunky, and while the customer portal is more user-friendly, it restricts details like voltages and current readings. And both are missing a vital piece of information, instantaneous power production. So with Enphase, you can't look down on your app and see how much your entire system is producing right now. Hoymiles monitoring is different. As soon as you look at it, it just makes sense. The customer has the same level of detail as the installer, and you can look at it and tell what your system is producing right now, which is a pretty simple feature, I would have thought. So Hoymiles wins on the monitoring platform as well. That's 2 out of 2. Now that we've covered monitoring, let's look at how the microinverters compare. First, how does Hoymiles compare to Enphase when there is no shade? I actually only did a month or a bit more of testing, but the guys down at Solar Technology and Electrical in Newcastle have been doing a comparison test for about 6 months. Our findings were very similar to theirs. Hoymiles seemed to work a little bit better than Enphase on early mornings and on cooler days. But Enphase seemed to work better in the middle hours of the day and in higher temperatures. In reality, the difference wasn't huge, but the fact that Hoymiles didn't like the hot days rang alarm bells, and I'll discuss that soon. Now, let's shade the panels. If you haven't seen my past videos, I explain that contrary to popular belief and contrary to microinverter marketing propaganda, microinverters do not necessarily produce better than string inverters in light or medium shade. Now, that's a big claim, but I've made a few videos explaining in depth that microinverters are not the shade solution that we all thought they were. The links are down in the notes below to those videos. But the unique advantage of microinverters is heavy shade. So how does Hoymiles compare to Enphase in significant shade? In short, Enphase wins. Look, not in all situations, just in some unique heavy shade situations. For example, when we shaded a quarter of a split cell panel, Hoymiles chose to use just the unshaded half. Enphase, however, found a better maximum power point and used the current from 3/4 of the panel. When we fully shaded one cell string, Enphase utilized the panel bypass diode, which prevented the whole panel from being dragged down. Hoymiles, however, never engaged the diode, so the whole panel was dragged down by the shaded portion. Well, what's going on here? Well, Enphase just has a superior maximum PowerPoint algorithm. Let's say that they have a better onboard computer that makes decisions on how to deal with shade. That's what happens when you've been the leading microinverter manufacturer for the last decade, I guess. Okay, so moving on, let's talk about operating temperature. If you know anything about electronics, then you'll know that things work better and last longer when they run cooler. Because we are jamming a full 1300 watts of power through one relatively small Hoymiles rooftop inverter, it runs damn hot. In fact, according to their own internal temperature readings, Hoymiles got up to 70 degrees internally. and I wasn't running it in harsh conditions. It was on a 1-to-1 power ratio instead of a 1.3 power ratio, and it was on tilt frames on a 25-degree spring day. If that little black box lasts past its warranty period, to be honest with you, I'll be mighty impressed. The Enphase microinverter continually ran at least 10 degrees cooler. So the rule of thumb in electronics would say that Enphase microinverter will last twice as long. Now that brings me to my final point, which is probably more important than any point that I've made so far. Which warranty is better? Well, Hoymiles has a 12-year warranty on the micros and Enphase has a 10-year warranty. On paper, same, same. For the communication boxes, Enphase has a 5-year warranty on the Envoy and Hoymiles just has a 3-year warranty on that little DTU communication box. Well, that's pretty crap for both Enphase and Hoymiles because if the monitoring fails in 3 or 5 years, you'll have to replace it in order to know if your microinverters fail. And remember, as I mentioned earlier, Enphase warranty document states that if your micros are not continuously connected to the internet, then your microinverter warranty is void. Incidentally, both Hoymiles and Enphase say in their warranty document that they don't cover labour to replace the faulty product. Well, they actually have to under Australian consumer law, and in reality, both companies have agreements with installers to pay for labour. But for whatever reason, neither company seems to want to say that in their warranty document. If you've got any ideas why that is, let me know in the comments below. But warranty on paper is worthless if the company doesn't actually honour their warranty. Enphase have been pretty good with a warranty over the last 10 years or so. Well, not perfect in my opinion, but they're pretty good. What about Hoymiles? They popped up in Australia 12 months ago. Will Hoymiles stay around in the Aussie market? Who knows? They have some pretty solid competition in Enphase. Will installers be willing to back this new Hoymiles product? So for confidence in the warranty, Enphase obviously wins hands down. And from the conversations that I've had, most installers will find it hard to put faith in Hoymiles. They just don't have the time in the market. They don't have the runs on the board. Okay, so let's summarize. Well, if you install your Hoymiles on a complicated roof, then your panels are probably not going to be in groups of four, so you won't get the full advantage of the 4-for-1 Hoymiles pricing. But it'll still be cheaper than an Enphase system. Next, Hoymiles monitoring is cheaper and better, and unlike Enphase, you don't need to keep it connected to the internet in order to keep your microinverter warranty. Now, that's good. If you have a heavily shaded roof, my test showed that Enphase works a little bit better. If you have a lightly shaded roof, my earlier video shows that you'll probably be as well off with a string inverter with a quality global maximum power point tracker. And if you're worried about safety, micros are safer than basic string inverters, but a string inverter with AFCI is as safe as houses. Keep tuned for my upcoming video on AFCI. If you're concerned about longevity, then the Hoymiles inverter runs ridiculously hot. I think it's reasonable to be concerned about the Hoymiles inverter failing. And now, if you're concerned about warranty, Enphase has a great track record. Hoymiles has no track record to speak of. So at MC Electrical, we won't be selling Hoymiles. We'll be sticking with Enphase for heavily shaded or small and complicated roofs. We'll recommend a quality string inverter like Fronius for every other application. Let me know your thoughts. Are you a fan of microinverters in general? If so, why? And do you find the Hoymiles price point tempting if so? Before you go, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. I've got a heap more test results in the pipeline. My next review is on Goodwee inverters. They've got a pretty interesting inverter that I've been testing for the last few months. So subscribe and hit that notification bell if you are keen for more. My name's Mark. Thanks for watching and I'll catch you next time.